and said, of 100 pages, no whale. See, yesterday we had a seminar in Usman University conducted by a students, Democratic Students Union. See, their anger, I think we can understand, annihilating the caste, how caste class issues have to be resolved in order to get revolution in this country. The students, how eagerly they are discussing these issues, but these people bringing 100-page entire issue, they quoted from annihilation of caste, no article speaks how to annihilate the caste. In fact, very it's a mockery to say, the word untouchability has not come from Hinduism. That's what the issue says. It's a travesty. Who believes that word Hinduism, the word untouchability, they say that not come from Hinduism. It is from Islam. How does it possible? It has come from medieval ages. You see, the medieval ages is a Muslims, not Islam. Muslims are invading. So the dominant caste women were running away. So these mlechas are coming. So they call them as a mlechas. There is a history. Yes, it is a history, but distorted history. So mlechas coming. So women folk went and hide somewhere. So that is the origin of untouchability in India, not the Vedas, not the other scriptures. How do you believe? Can you believe if even ordinary person who reads Ambedkar can? I don't think so. It is a believable untouchability, annihilation of caste. See, I reviewed 4 or 5 articles. I laughed at. Why I know? You see, Ambedkar, he professed, what is his name? One who was responsible for collapse of World Trading Towers, Bin Laden. 75 years ago, Ambedkar professed about Bin Laden. That's what this issue says. Can you believe? See, I am reading, you see. How this is a Makwana. I think they said, no, how anti Dr. Satyanarayan and Anand sir, all are they said. Anti-Islam, anti-Muslim. The context I would like to put it, but let me say what Makwana. Makwana is a Dalit title, I believe, in Gujarat. But he says that, you see, 2-3 things are very, very disturbing. How they can write? You see, I am quoting him. According to Makwana, the whole world is facing the menace of Islamic terrorism, and Dr. Ambedkar has presented a realistic analysis of menace of Islamic terrorism 75 years ago. That is 100% true. He gave in 100%. He put 100 word and put that as true. So how, what I think this is a nonsense. There is no sense in it. Yes, it is, you can, even if you want to write a magazine like this for your Pracharaks to appropriate Ambedkar, this is not the way to write. This is not the way to write. Yes, if you want to propagate material, you propagate it. But this is not the way to propagate Ambedkar. I think that is a very disturbing. See, this kind of thing, he says that Ambedkar was for, as a part of anti-Muslim, he wanted to have a uniform civil code. Yes, I teach Ambedkar thought very modestly in university. I teach Ambedkar thought. I teach Dalit politics university very modestly. I am not saying that I am very perfect. He never spoke about uniform civil code. He talked about Hindu code. First, you have to be reformed yourself. Then you talk of uniform civil code. There is a difference between uniform civil code and Hindu code. See, I am saying, it's very, I think lawyers are interpreting very beautifully this one. This is a legalistic way of understanding Ambedkar. That also distorted. You see, sir, thus this kind of, they put it, revisiting Ambedkar. For whom you want to revisit Ambedkar? As I said, if a communist want to revisit Ambedkar, he is truly revisiting Ambedkar to annihilate the caste. That's my belief. If a reformer wants to revisit Ambedkar, he is in search of Ambedkar, true Ambedkar, to reform this society. If it is reform or revolutionary, whatever it may be. But this revisit for whom? You want to Hinduize the country? For that you want to revisit Ambedkar? Yesterday he was false god for you, and all of a sudden he becomes a true god for you. How does it possible? You should have some honesty, no? Yesterday you said that he is a false god. Don't worship him. And today you are asking, he is a true god, we must worship for him. Worship him. On what basis? Distortive thing. History, polity, society, culture, economy, all spheres of Ambedkar knowledge has been distorted in this issue. If they want to do, we don't know. But you see, one education is a professor, and she writes, I think it's very, I'm not generalizing. See, she says that how education is very important. Ambedkar gave a philosophy of education in his own way. I'm not saying you follow it. See, the whole controversy today, it's a, two controversies are very, very important. One controversy, as in I think Dr. Satyanarayana said, of all those controversies, added to that, there was a cartoon in NCERT books. Ambedkar sitting on nail, and then he had a whip, and then he's, you know, see what kind of symbolizing this? He's sitting on the nail, and he has a holding whip, and as if Nehru offering something. So Nehru is a very progressive. Ambedkar is not allowing the country to progress. So he's sitting on the nail. That's a very big controversy we lost. I think there was a debate. And now the present debate is ongoing. I think Anand sir also responded. So the debate between Gandhi and Ambedkar. This introduction to Annihilation of Caste written by Arundhati Roy. Debate between Gandhi and Ambedkar. Now, if you read EPW, current issue, last issue and previous issues, debate between Arundhati Roy and Rajmohan Gandhi. So it's a debate. See, this debate has gone nowhere. Why do you want to confuse the people? Arundhati Roy attacked Gandhi. Gandhi grandson is attacking the Arundhati Roy. So now debate has become these two people, and Ambedkar is nowhere. After I think 1 year she took to write 10-page response in EPW to Rajmohan Gandhi, very elaborate response. The whole response is that, as if I said wrong, this is the words of I think Arundhati Roy, as if said something wrong against Mahatma Gandhi, so his grandson is coming and defending his grandfather to tell that. I think she wrote, I'm not saying there is no substance, to tell that point, and the debate is prolonged. I'm not comparing with RSS to her. So this kind of, she says that in education, how she says that, her name is the Rege. I don't know what comes from. She's a very important, this one. Yadav, Sushma Yadav. In this article, a vision for change. There's so many things which are really disturbs, and people like us, you know, it's very. So she says, she says that according to Arthur, Ambedkar convinced that a good social order or society has to go through two tests. Namely, the test of justice and the test of utility. Then I just read some of the Ambedkar volumes, and where is these two concepts comes from? Then I started reading, because he's an educationist. Then she got these principles from pragmatism. Then, okay, I got the clue. So I went to read Ambedkar's space of D-Way. Then I don't think so. He talks about the tests of utility. Tests of justice he talks. How education must be. See, she quotes. She says that how distortion happens here. So very, very, very distortive. How the RSS provoked education is implemented in this country. I think this is the evidence in this. Ambedkar, she says that. See, in that Ambedkar says that if you give education to strata of Indian society which has a vested interest in maintaining the caste system for the advantages it gives them, then the caste system will be strengthened. Now, whom you are giving to education? To strengthen or to destroy it? What kind of education that you are giving? You nowhere said about your education policy. You have nowhere mentioned about your annihilation of caste. Nowhere you mentioned how untouchability has to be. Including your own reformers' quotations were not there. At least, RSS have some vision of untouchability that itself is not reflected. What kind of dishonesty this is? How do you say this kind of words that, you know, Ambedkar is, you know, this and that. Ambedkar, you know, talked about Bin Laden. Ambedkar, anti-Muslim. Ambedkar, anti-communist. I don't understand, I think, this kind of thing. The last one, I think, it's a very interesting to say that. See, as a part of neoliberal, it's a very, very intended, intensive application that they want to destroy Ambedkar. They apply this one. Neoliberal. Ambedkar, according to this author, is a very, very interesting, you know, this is, Ambedkar, 40 years ago, Ambedkar suggested to have a LPG. Liberalization, privatization, and globalization. This, they said it. Ambedkar said, 40 years back, this privatization, we the fools, they use, we the fools, we could not follow Ambedkar. Hence, all the state governments in this country delayed. Hence, Ambedkar was undermined. What a praise for Ambedkar. Is it a praise or you are, what is, Ambedkar said 40 years back, you the fools, you have not followed Ambedkar. So that's why we are here. So you should have followed 40 years back. He accused all the state governments, including the BJP. Yeah, good. You yourself a fool, then you should have followed. This is, you see how they are. Then immediately they quotes, Ambedkar was for nationalization of agriculture land. How does it possible? You are saying that Ambedkar 40 years back, he announced liberalization policy. India must follow liberalization. And the next word he says that Ambedkar said nationalization of land. You should have some sense, no, to even put also words. Because these are two contradictory things. So you are saying, a lot of things. This is how they have written. And you see, you are trying to revisit Ambedkar. Yes, revisit Ambedkar. Even if you want, okay, we forget, suppose. We don't reply for them. Caste is an important issue that has to be taken. Then, if you want to annihilate it, why you are distributing Mangala Sutras? What is the text of annihilation of caste says? Inter-caste marriage. Any reform, that Ambedkar himself said is a reformistic method. Okay? Then, even in that also, how you are distributing, instead of performing inter-caste marriages, you are distributing Mangala Sutras. What is this? Whom you are propagating? You are propagating Ambedkar or you are propagating, what is that you are propagating? I think you are not telling to us. The context, I think that is very, very important of all this. Why they wanted to bring out very, very systematical, I think all earlier speakers, they told, on democracy, on polity, how Ambedkar is relevant. Irrelevance of that, you know, that they are projecting that this is what Ambedkar, and for which we wanted to revisit Ambedkar, and for that we wanted to have Akhanda Bharat. I think that has to be I think one has to take seriously, and we appreciate Tarkam's initiation in this, because yes, in most of our students also, we wanted to have, tomorrow also we are going to have a seminar in our university by Dr. Anand, and we wanted to discuss, and you see, many, I thoroughly discussed my, you see, just I one how I started, then I'll start. After decades of mockery, Ambedkar, Baba Sahib Ambedkar, they are telling, I wanted to say this point and conclude it. See, they are challenging the RSS people are saying that all other Ambedkarites are pseudo-Ambedkarites. We are the real Ambedkarites. They said in this. They said, yes, it is there in the magazine. All other Ambedkarites are pseudo-Ambedkarites. That's what I am reading. So Ambedkar ideas and his movement, the pundits and columnists of organizers, the mouthpiece of RSS brought out a special issue titling Revisiting Ambedkar. The move of RSS to revisit Ambedkar, contrary to the earlier responses, this time it is totally for the appropriation of Ambedkar. The context in which they wanted to revisit is twisted revisiting. The twisting of revisiting Ambedkar has to be understood critically by all the progressive forces of in this country. That's what my appeal. Author in these articles, special issue, claims that the present generation of Ambedkarites are fake, are pseudo-Ambedkarites. This is what they mention. All present generation Ambedkarites are fake and pseudo-Ambedkarites. And the new twist in this issue is that the true Ambedkarites are the true Hindus. Comes from Sangha Parivar. Oh, what a great... However, the question is, who is true Ambedkar is not resolved in this issue. The most disgusting side of the special issue is that the project is to assimilate Ambedkar to the very different theoretical framework. Yes, you have a Marxist thought. It's a thought, Ambedkar thought. You use it, but you cannot, as I said, distort it. It's a thought process, as I think Dr. Anand says it. There are some gaps in Ambedkar thought. We are not saying that it's a full-fledged. Marx himself said there are gaps in his theory. Lenin started correcting, then Mao started correcting, others are attributing to Gramsci contributed, and there are some gaps. I think there are works are being done, or works are coming up on Ambedkar, as I think rightly put by Dr. Anand, to reconstruct Ambedkar. But in the context of reconstructing this destruction of Ambedkar, these two contradictions have to be understood. The relevance of Ambedkar in this country is going to be understood if this is the dialectical opposition. One sections are distorting and one section is trying to, as I said, the students, they are trying to read Ambedkar, reinterpreting Ambedkar. They wanted to thorough read Ambedkar to use to have caste and class struggle in this country in order to wage a war against the whatever the imperial and the caste forces of in this country. If that is the case, I think this issue, I think, nowhere stands even to the students' level. That's what my appeal. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you.
Mitulara. చెప్పవలసింది చాలా ఉంది, చెప్పవలసింది కనీసం ఈ రోజు నుంచి మొదలు పెడదాం. ఇందులో భాగంగానే ఈ సెమినార్ని ఏర్పాటు చేశాం. ఈ సెమినార్కి మేము అందించవలసిన సమాచారం ఆ పుస్తక రూపంలో పెట్టాము. ఆ బుక్లెట్ని మేము తీసుకొచ్చాము, మాకు చేతనంది చేసాము. ఈ బుక్లెట్ అయిన తర్వాత వచ్చే చర్చ, దానిని బట్టి ఇంకా మేము చేయబోయే ప్రయత్నాల్ని మెరుగుపరుచుకుంటాం. ఇందులో పాల్గొనడానికి వచ్చినటువంటి మిత్రులందరికీ నేను ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేస్తున్నాను. ఇది ఓట్ ఆఫ్ థ్యాంక్స్ కాదు. ముందే చెప్పాను, చెప్పవలసింది చాలా ఉంది, ఎంతో ఉంది. ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆనంద్ తేల్తుమ్మడి ఆయన ఈ సబ్జెక్ట్ మీద చాలా తీవ్రమైనటువంటి యుద్ధమే